Let me complicate the situation a bit. Say I have Cl whose molarity is 10 power minus 3. What's the pH? pH would be log of minus log of 10 power minus 3, which is 3. Very well. Suppose the molarity of HCl was 10 power minus 4. Then what's the pH? pH should be 4. Suppose it was 10 power minus 5 molarity. What's the pH? It should be 5, right? If the molarity is 10 power minus 8 molar, what's the pH? So I hope got it that pH in this case will not be equal to 8. It is not equal to 8. What's the simple reason? It's a solution of a strong acid, right? No way that the pH will be on the side of a base. If you have pH greater than 7, that means the solution is basic, right? That is a basic solution, right? Now, it's impossible that if you put some HCl, how much ever less amount, in pure water, the pH will become greater than 7. No, your answer has to be pH is less than 7. So what's wrong? Was this right? Was this right? Was this right? If they were right, then what? Why is this not 8? Why is this not 8? I can give you some time to think over it and can write your reason. What? Why do you think the answer is not 8? I know some of you have got it, got the reason. Let's actually find out the pH. We have HCl. We have HCl aqueous and said it is 10 power minus 8 molar given to you. We know it's a strong acid, plus it is so dilute that it is fully going to break up into its ions. And what you get ultimately is 0 HCl, there is no HCl, and all of it has converted to H plus, so 10 power minus 8. H plus and 10 power minus 8 Cl minus, right? So is the concentration of H plus 10 power minus 8 in the solution? It is an aqueous solution. In the solution, is it 10 power minus 8? No, it is not 10 power minus 8. It's not 10 power minus 8. And the reason is because we cannot forget the other player, which is always there. And particularly in this case, it cannot be ignored, which is water itself, right? Your H2O, if I can dare to write it as aqueous, is itself, meaning to say 2H2O, it is going to give you H plus and OH minus, right? H2O itself is going to produce H plus and OH minus, right? As pure water, how much it produces? It produces a 10 power minus 7, right? 10 power minus 7. So, what is greater? 10 power minus 7, 10 power minus 8. 10 power minus 7 is a bigger value, right? Your 10 power minus 7 is equal to 10 into 10 power minus 8, right? So, it is 10 times greater. So, can I ignore the H plus amount coming from water? Not at all. Not at all. Why had we ignored earlier? Because earlier, I was giving you values like 10 power, say, minus 3. So, you had H plus 10 power minus 3, Cl minus 10 power minus 3. Here also water was giving H plus from its own side in the vicinity of say 10 power minus 7. So 10 power minus 3 plus, if I say I have to count water fully, which is again not appropriate, I'll tell you why. But if I say you have 10 power minus 3 molar HCl, the amount of H plus in the solution is so much from HCl and so much from water, say, so much from HCl and so much from water. And if you actually add, it is almost going to be 10 power minus 3 itself. Because if you see, then the addition is something like this. You have 1 into 10 power minus 3. And this guy will be point, if I say 0.1, it is 10 power minus 6. Into 10 power minus 6, 0.01. Then 10 power minus 5, 0.001, 10 power minus 4, 0.0001, then it is your 10 power minus 3. So 10 power minus 7 is 0.0001 into 10 power minus 3. So 1 into 10 power minus 3 plus so much is going to be exactly, the exact value will be 1.0001 into 10 power minus 3. So when you find the pH, this is hardly going to make any, this part is hardly going to make any difference. And your pH is going to come as 3 itself. So it would have been slightly on the lower side of 3, but it would show, I mean, it is not going to matter in the initial few decimal places, and hence you will write the value as 3 itself. Okay, so let's get back to solving the question, the problem at hand. And what is that? You have HCl, which was 10 power minus 8, right? 10 power minus 8. Just 10 power minus 8, 10 power minus 8, 10 power minus 8. So obviously, the H plus in water in the solution is not 10 power minus 8 alone. It's a value which is greater than 10 power minus 7, because the pH has to come less than 7, we know for sure. And it is greater than 10 power minus 7 because water is contributing. So water is water contributing so much? Can I say that my H plus equal to what it was getting contributed from HCl is a 1 into 10 power minus 8, and what it is getting contributed from water is 10 power minus 7, which is a 10 into 10 power minus 8. So is my H plus aqueous 11 into 10 power minus 8? Looks like, right? I hope you got that right. The answer is no, it is not. It is not so much. It is int 11 into 10 power minus 8. Now you will wonder why. So can anybody tell us why? Think about it. Now you have to put an index over here, common ion effect. The reason is, I hope you have thought about the reason. The reason is that this equation what I have written over here with just an arrow is not like that. You have written it many times earlier. And how is it? It's an equilibrium sign, right? I mean, you might say that it is mostly backwards. Okay, it's, I mean, this, these two, H plus and OH minus, is hardly any. But anyways, we have got ionic product value of this. Ionic product value always remains as a constant. Again and again, I'm telling you. And what is that? What is that? What is the ionic product? The product sides, whatever the ions are, we'll take the product of that. That is your Kw. Kw value is a constant for a given temperature, 10 power minus 14 at 25 degrees Celsius, right? So that is the constant. Now, what happens? Will this equilibrium remain as a 10 power minus 7 and a 10 power minus 7? Obviously not. It is not going to remain like that. Why? Because H plus has been provided by some other source. H plus has come from HCl. What is happening is, we already have 10 power minus 8 H plus coming from HCl. And at that stage, I mean, when we say the water is not dissociated at all, assuming it is not dissociated at all and is going to dissociate, and it is going to give a 10 power minus 7, 10 power minus 7, before that happens, say that H plus is already getting contributed by HCl, and at that stage there was no OH, right? Now what is going to happen is, water is going to give, because after all there is a small tiny forward reaction happening. Is it going to give a 2? Is it going to give full 10 power minus 7 OH minus and H plus? That means, is 10 power minus 7 amount of H2O going to dissociate? So much going to dissociate and give so many H plus and OH minus? How much ever OH comes from water, those many H plus will come, right? How much ever OH minus comes, those many H plus will come. That's one molecule of water gives one H plus and one OH minus, right? My question again is it going to dissociate, and is it going to give 10 power minus 7, or do you think it is going to give more, or do you think it is going to give less? Hope you got the answer. There was nothing present, was no presence of H plus already, it would have given 10 power minus 7. But if there is presence of H plus, then the amount given would be less than, the amount given will be less than 10 power minus 7 because of this common ion, because of the common ion. This H plus ion has been provided in water by HCl. So water is not going to dissociate fully, and the backward reaction is going to become enhanced. If it was already 10 power minus 7, which was the case, the story goes something like this. You have water, and that water was dissociated, and you had 10 power minus 7 H plus, and you have 10 power minus 7 OH minus. Now comes in your acid HCl. That HCl suppresses the dissociation because it comes with its own H plus, it provides H plus, so this reaction starts going backwards. The amount dissociated from water no longer remains 10 power minus 7, it becomes less. So one water gives one OH minus and one H plus, so say it becomes a value less than 10 power minus 7 X. OH minus is also X, and wherein what I am saying, what I am contesting, or what I am proposing is X is a value less than 10 power minus 7. It's no longer as much as 10 power minus 7, and we'll have to find that. And it's not a difficult calculation at all. Why? Because we know that no matter what, at 25 degrees Celsius, your ionic product of H plus and OH minus is going to be 10 power minus 14. So that's a single variable X over there, and we can easily find it out. So we'll have X plus 10 power minus 8 times X is going to be 10 power minus 14. So the equation is X square 10 power minus 8X minus 10 power minus 14 is equal to 0. Let's just apply the quadratic formula to get your X value, and what will that be? X is equal to minus B, which is minus 10 power minus 8, plus minus, since we have got a minus over there and we know it is signs going on, we have to have a positive value, so I'm just going to take the plus here. And then we have b square would be 10 power minus 16 minus 4ac. We have got a minus sign already there, so it becomes plus 4ac is 1 and c is 10 power minus 14. So 4 into 10 power minus 14, this whole thing divided by 2a, which is 2, right? I'm just hoping to get an X value which is less than 10 power minus 7, right? That was the argument. So it should be something, if it is measured in 10 power minus 8 values, so less than 10 into 10 power minus 8, right? So a 9 into 10 power minus 8, a 8 into 10 power minus 8, whatever. See, so 10 power minus 16 and this is 10 power minus 14, we'll rather write both of them in terms of 10 power minus 16. So what is this? This 4 into 10 power minus 14 is actually a 400 into 10 power minus 16, right? So this under root thing becomes how much? This whole under root thing becomes how much? This becomes 1 into 10 power minus 16 plus 400 into 10 power minus 16. So 401 into 10 power minus 16 under root of that. 401 is, under root will be almost 20, right? Almost 20. So this part is your 20, is 400 into 10 power minus 16, under root is 20 into 10 power minus 8, this part. So I'll just write it. Just 10 plus under root of 401 is almost 20, under root of 10 power minus 16 is 10 power minus 8, 2 gives you minus 1, which is 19 into 10 power minus 8 by 2. 19 by 2 is 9.5 into 10 power minus 8. So I'm a little relieved to see the values, because I was just wanting to get it less than 10 into 10 power minus 8, and it is coming 9.5 into 10 power minus 8. By mistake, if somebody would have taken that water is fully dissociating and would have taken 10 into 10 power minus 8, which is 10 power minus 7, 10 into 10 power minus 8, then to your answer wouldn't have been that much off. It would have been wrong, but not that much off. Anyways, looking at all of this, what do we get? What do we get? What is the concentration of H plus? The concentration of H plus is, I'll just clear the stuff a bit. So we have just calculated that our X value is coming as 9.5 into 10 power minus 8 just less than minus 7, H plus concentration, that was the main thing, H plus concentration, H plus aqueous concentration is equal to 0.5 plus 1, which is 10.5 into 10 power minus 8, this calculation. 1 into 10 power minus 8 plus 9.5 into 10 power minus 8, which is 10.5 into 10 power minus 8. pH value is going to be accordingly, this value, this whole thing is greater than 10 power minus 7, right? Because 10 power minus 7 is 10 into 10 power minus 8. So I'm going to get a pH less than 7, and that is what I was wanting to get. And your calculation would be, take minus negative log of all this, you know how it comes, so I'm just skipping writing all those lines. So your 10 power minus 8 gives you a plus 8 minus log of 10.5. This, you can check your log tables to get the answer. Log of 10 is equal to 1. At log of 10.5 will be slightly more than 1. You have to check your tables to get it. So the tables show the value of log of 10.5 as 1.021. So your pH is going to be 8 minus 1.021, which is going to be in the range of 6 point something, good for us, so 6.9, and there's a 2.1, so 7.9, right? So that's it, guys. The big value is here with us. It is, the pH is 6.979. It had to be less than 7, and it is less than 7. And most part of it is contributed by water itself. The H plus ions is contributed by water itself and not the acid. The acid is increasing the H plus concentration a bit, and it is becoming, the H plus concentration is becoming a 10.5 into 10 power minus 8 instead of a 10 into 10 power minus 8. Because it's not like the acid is not dissociating, the acid is fully dissociating, it is giving its own part of 1 into 10 power minus 8, but it is reducing the dissociation of water by a small amount, and the total amount of H plus ion is coming as 10.5 into 10 power minus 8. Your pH is less than 7, which had to be because it was an acidic solution. So I hope you're getting the point. So this is a very common and important example of common ion. The main crux over here is, if the solution is acidic, if you have put an acid, 10 power minus 10 molar HCl, pH to be less than 7. How much ever near to 7, maybe the pH comes almost 7, 6.999 I can write by the looks of it, because a 10 power minus 8 itself gave a 6.97, 979 or something, right? So this might be 6.9999 whatever, but it is less than 7. It's not, pH won't be 10, right? Keeping that in mind, just do one question for this part and I'll be satisfied that you have understood how to handle common ion with strong acids or strong bases. I mean, it is actually handling a common ion of water. For the dissociation of water, 2O, we are providing a common ion to this water dissociation, and water is not dissociating as much and it is going backwards in its reaction. Instead of 10 power minus 7, 10 power minus 7, it is becoming less than that. So that's what is driving the question. So just note a question. Find the pH for, say, 5 into 10 power minus 8 molar NaOH. What's the pH? Should it be less than 7? Should it be more than 7? And not only that, what is the exact value? The, say, 4 significant digits. So best of luck with this. That ends this part, and now we are going to start with another kind of solution, which is a solution of a weak acid or a solution of a weak base. So the concepts of doing weak acid would be similar to the concepts of doing weak base. So we'll handle it together, as over here the concept of doing strong acid and the concept of doing strong base is the same, right?